12. Well, within 10 years, more than half of all Americans will be obese, and one in four will be considered severely obese, meaning they will be more than 100 pounds overweight. That's coming from the New England Journal of Medicine, and based on data from more than 6 million U.S. adults, the study found that the South and Midwest U.S. will be the hardest hit. Experts say this could have a devastating impact on the U.S. healthcare system. The study stresses that prevention is the only way to try and slow this epidemic. So I know we're all having a lot of eggnog. I'm having cookies for breakfast this week. I've already told on myself to the doctor. But here to talk more about this study and what it means for Americans is an endocrinologist with Scripps Health, Dr. Ken
Fujioka.
Fujioka, I want to get that correct. This is important, what we're talking about here, because this is the time of year we're all splurging, just a little splurge here and there. And then what happens is March, we're still splurging, and now we've got a serious problem on our hands here in America. So let me ask you this. What is a healthy weight? So we see people on Instagram, they look perfect, super skinny. And then we see people very overweight. There has to be a happy medium. What's a good weight for somebody?
It's tough because it really is different for everybody. So some folks are meant to be a little bit heavier. But when you talk about that severely overweight population that we're worried about, one quarter of Americans in 10 years are going to be severely overweight. That's scary. We're talking, like you said, 70, 80, 100 pounds overweight. So that's obvious. That's the easiest. But some people, you know, 10, 20 pounds overweight, no big deal. Other folks, okay, it's a problem. So we use this thing called body mass index, and it works okay, but it's just a rough guideline. And it's really just trying to stay at your healthy weight for your height, and again, it varies from individual to individual.
Yeah, you can Google it. You can Google it and find it, and try to stay within that. So, what is the most important thing that came out of this study to you?
Probably two things. One is this is a very accurate study. Unfortunately, if you ask a woman how much she weighs, she will tend to tell you that she's a little less than she really is. So we've been under-predicting the numbers. But men actually are no different. Men, if you ask them how tall they are, they will tell you they're 2 or 3 inches taller than they are. So it turned out both sexes were kind of giving us false numbers, and that's why we're really worried, because now that we know the real numbers, when you actually measure it, we're looking at a lot of Americans that are going to be very overweight. So one is this is accurate. The other one is that, and again, it's what you said earlier, half of Americans are going to be considered what we call obese. So that means somebody who's about 40 pounds overweight, and they're going to get medical problems. But it's the other number we're scared of. It's this severely overweight. So if they're severely overweight, that means, again, 70, 80, 100 pounds overweight, they're going to get a lot of problems, not just one or two. They're going to get liver problems. They're going to get heart problems. They're going to get bad joint problems, diabetes, and that's the group we're really scared about.
Everything, all that weight, that's a real drag on the system overall.
Yeah.
And so why do you think people have such a hard time with this, and why are we not able to, I mean, the government has done so many things, mandated this, mandated putting calories on menus, mandated, but that doesn't seem to be helping or curbing this. So what's the problem?
It's just tough because there's a lot of different issues here. So one is what we call the biology. So it turns out whatever is the highest weight someone's been at, the body will try and go back to that weight for the rest of their life.
Really?
Yeah, it's scary.
That's wrong.
It is. It's scary. The good news is that we now know all the hormones that control this. So it's probably in about 10 years, you're going to be able to go to a obesity medicine specialist. So these are doctors who specialize in this, and this is the fastest growing specialty in medicine right now. And they'll be able to give you hormones to correct your metabolism. But right now, and they learned this from, believe it or not, The Biggest Loser. It was a great story, but they followed those people 7 years, and they found they were dropping their metabolism so low that it was almost impossible for them to keep their weights down. So it was really tough.
What's our big takeaway as we leave everybody at the Christmas holiday season? What's the takeaway here?
I think the biggest thing right now is it's the holidays. Enjoy them, but just try not to gain weight right now. That should be everybody's goal. Once we get through the holidays, okay, January 1, whatever is your date that you're going to reckon with, then okay, let's make some changes and come up with a plan. And the plan's going to have at least 2 or 3 components. One is find a diet that you can do.
That you can live with.
That's right. Believe me, they all work. You want to do keto, you want to do intermittent fasting, you want to count calories, you want to do low carb, low fat. That's okay. Find what works and do it correctly. Two, You're going to have to get some exercise in there, mm-hmm. however you can do it. But find that's what's safe and what you can do.
Okay. Doctor, those are great tips. That's something good to think of. And we won't have cookies for breakfast after January 1st. All right. Thank you so much for coming on. We appreciate it.